supporting all you England fans out there. And there's a smattering of bloke round about here. Good to see you guys. And before I introduce my other two mates, I want to let you know. Come on in, come on in. We're making history here tonight. Yeah, we're making history. There is 30,000 of us here in this stadium. Give yourself a round of applause. First time Max Smart Stadium has been packed out since 2003. Isn't that fantastic, Johnson?
It's good to be here.
Yes, and I found some of the good fans here right down by the time. I've got Mike here. Mike, how are you feeling, mate?
Oh, awesome, man. Trip of lifetime.
Fantastic. Rick, you excited about everyone's prospects tonight?
Yeah, I'm going to count that. Love it.
Absolutely. We've got Mark here. Mark, score prediction. What are you going to get for us?
I'd like to say he's going to win, but I don't think the other big Tonga Parks has been.
We're going to give it to Tonga. And we're going to go to the quiz stand. And we're going to go to Justin. Justin, how are you?
I'm absolutely fantastic.
Marvellous. Hey, so what we're going to do here, it's a game called So You Think You're a Fan. So we're going to have some questions come up on the big screen then, and you've just got to tell me if it's fact or fiction. Simple enough.
Okay, yeah, we'll give it a go.
All right, let's have a look at question number one. All right, Justin. Here we go. Jermaine McGilvery is England's leading try scorer in the tournament. Justin, is that fact or fiction?
It's fact.
He's going to bed. Let's see if he's right. It's a fact! Alright, we're 1-1 at this stage. Let's go to the next question. James Graham's 88 tackles is the most of any England player in the opening three matches. Justin, fact or fiction?
Fiction.
Fiction. There's a bit of drama there. He's 2 of 2 here. Alright, let's see if he can go 100 a seat. England has had 3 goal kickers during the opening 3 matches. Just going to ask you, is that fact or fiction?
Fact.
He's going with facts. Let's have a look, is he right? Oh, it's fiction. Gareth Widdop has been England's only goal kicker in the tournament so far. He did pretty well, 2 out of 3. All right, let's send it over to our Tongan fans. Jandals, you got someone to play fact or fiction, my man?
How's it going? Time to play So You Think You're a Fan. But first, check out this outfit. Check it out. Tosu Tonga, the Underworld Championship belt, ain't got nothing on that. Munich, let's check out the big screen for your first question. Here we go. Fact or fiction? We'll have the questions up on the screen to real soon. As it comes out, check out the outfit. And you've got all your family behind you as well, supporting.
I wish they were my family.
I love the corner, you can get a close up of that. The fine mats, worn by the fine man. The corned beef, and of course, it wouldn't be a Tongan Rugby League World Cup supporter without the flag. Here we go, then we have the questions up on the screen. All right, here we go, standing by. Fact or fiction, David Fusitua scored a hat-trick of tries and Tonga's 28 points to 22 win over New Zealand. Mane, fact or fiction?
That's true.
You saw the sign, he's going truth, fact. What's on the screen? Correct.
Alright, the second question. Tonga's 28-22 win over New Zealand was the first time they have beaten him in a Rugby League World Cup tournament. Fact or fiction?
Eel!
Eel!
Eel! Ow, Vito! Ow, Vito!
Yes! Congratulations.
All right, you're 2 from 2. One more, you get the trifecta. Question 3, fact or fiction. Jason Tomalolo scored Tonga's first try of the tournament in a 50 points to 4 win over Scotland in round 1. Fact or fiction? Mana, what do you say?
Am I lying?
I'm not too sure what that means. I think it means he's saying it's not true. It is fiction, you got it right. Michael Jennings, score Tonga's opening try. I like it. Where are the England supporters?
The prediction of the score.
Así que por mí, creo que con la hija de Squad, o por mí, me decía, no era caído nada, no te tocó.
Have a good time,
boys.
Let's have a good time.
grass and ground lie once thunderous volcanoes, watching over the sands, the seas, the history of their domain and its works of art. Over the cultures that live here, the people that play here, and the ones that stay here. Auckland, love you again.
Pretty exciting, really. It's the day I got my new year, so I'm really looking forward to it.
You got a bit of gun.
The sick man does think tasty.
Then it looks fantastic.
Well, I should be able to find a spot there for first.
Jesus!
Thanks for coming to the game today. We really appreciate your support. The League for Life Foundation needs your support too. League for Life is the official charity of the Rugby League World Cup and the New Zealand Rugby League. If anyone from the League community needs help through serious injury, illness or disability, League for Life is there to offer grants and support. So please make a donation here at the ground. Look them up or give a little, or go to www.nzrl.co.nz. Click on the League for Life link.
Mount Smart Stadium, how we feeling? Kickoff's almost close. Oh, come on guys, let's give it a bit more. That's good. Hey, I managed to find an Englishman in amongst the CEO of Tottenham supporters here. Andy, how are you this evening, mate?
Yeah, looking forward to this. Maybe in England, definitely.
Yeah, well, what about the confidence there? And this is the first Rugby League World Cup that we've been to at this tournament in 2017.
So, yes, we spent the week with New Zealand playing the Masters Rugby League tournament down the Rotorua. Again, three games down there, and then the first test ever between England and New Zealand, or Great Britain and New Zealand, to the Masters Rugby League, and brilliant week. The people in New Zealand have been absolutely fantastic. They've been welcomed everywhere, and it's my first trip to New Zealand, and I'll definitely be coming back.
Oh, brilliant. And you yourself, you're playing prop, second prop in this Masters tournament?
No, I'm definitely a winger. One of the slowest wingers that really came up.
And you've been travelling around New Zealand, you've seen lots of the Tongan flags on cars as you've been going by?
Oh yes, it's been fantastic. I mean, we all watched the New Zealand Tonga game and everybody was cheering for Tonga. And that was just a fantastic game. So, really forward to today.
And we've just had the Tongan teams walking out here for their warm-ups. But Andy, what have you made of the performances of Wayne Bennett so far?
Winner.
kicking for McGilvray, looking for a third. Backing up Wilkins, and it's a second. Leaps from the air, like a Cape Crusader. And another try for England. Foxen, they're working left again. Winner, comes for Noga. Ball, he'll be tough to spot. And it's a stop that he can't win. As England defeats Papua New Guinea here in Melbourne, 36 points to 6.
I see red. I see Monday Maradona in the house. 30,000 plus in Nassau Stadium tonight, and I found myself the flyest of the Tonga girls in attendance. Now, guys, very seriously though, I've been driving up and down the Tonga for the last 2 weeks trying to get a flag. I couldn't find any. How many flags do you have on your cars? You got 100 Tongan flags on your calf?
Yeah, baby!
Alright, that's the right attitude. Speaking of yeah, babies, there's some good looking men in this Tongan team, right? Who is the hottest? Tyson Tomalolo, you have a fan. You have a fan right here. Let's check out this poster. Tyson Tomalolo features quite heavily. Daniel Tupou, and also Conrad Harrell. Are we excited about tonight?
No, excited!
Here's the question though, and I want everyone in the stadium to answer. Is Tonga going to the final next week? Yeah! I couldn't hear that, let me ask that again. Is Tonga going to the final next week? I think that's a yes. I think that's a resounding yes. Who's going to score the first try tonight?
Tonga!
Which player?
Titi Tamalolo!
I heard Titi Tamalolo in here. It sounds like the whole team's going to score a try tonight, is that right? And how far have you guys travelled to be here?
2 hours?
2 hours? Where are you from?
Hamilton!
They drove all the way from Hamilton to be here tonight. Tongan supporters all across the stadium, driven hours to be here. We could create history. Let's throw it with the John, who's got more Tongan supporters.
What about player of the match? Who do you think is going to be the player of the match?
Obviously, Sika Manu, man. But yeah, he said have some of my chocolate.
Where is everyone going to celebrate after the game tonight?
Papatoi, Konapa, and Halle Great South Road.
Wherever the people are, we have to celebrate. But if you're finished with Hannibal, Santa Claus, Merry Christmas, Santa Claus. Kokona!
Alright folks, we could be on the road to victory and the road to history. Let's check out the highlights that led to tonight. Here are some of the footage from last week's game. Tonga versus Lebanon.
Just an easy meter for them.
Oh, to the right side, to the outside, that's going to go.
Two runners on the inside looking for Moses, another behind play. Here to Charles Hennigan. Terrific play from Diane. Beautifully set up by Mitchell Moses and Robbie Farrer. Billy goes behind off the hand of that one.
We've got the Tongan team warming up there over on my right, so it's time to warm you guys up. How are you feeling? Come on, give us a wee bit more. Tonga, how are you feeling? We got the English fans, want to make some noise out there as well? Yeah, there's a few of you there. Absolutely love it. Daniels, it's going to be a sensational game here tonight between Tonga and England. Who are you looking forward to seeing the most?
I've been looking forward to tonight for the whole week. I'm a big fan of the big boys, yep. Sam Burgess and James Graham. Up against Andrew Fafina. There's going to be a lot of massive hits. I'm also looking to the big guys out in the back, the likes of Conrad Harrell. I used to love seeing him throw a kiss to his mum. Yeah. And my wish is for all the Tonga supporters, if Conrad Harrell scores a try tonight, and he throws a kiss to the camera, I want to see 30,000 Tonga supporters.
It's probably too much love for one man, I'm going to lie there. John,
yes.
You've met some wonderful people in your travels so far. Where have some of those people been coming from?
It's been epic. I know that there are people that have come out all the way from the United States of America. Let's hear if you've flown over all the way from the United States of America. What about Australia? What about Hamidonga? What about Otahuhu?
Alright guys, it's time to throw it up to Nick for the countdown rehearsal. Very simple, we start from 10, we go down to 0, and we make some noise. Nick, take it away, mate.
Alrighty, we've heard from the top.
Thank you.
the ball on a wee bit here, a wee bit of a fumble. Nick, sorry for throwing you that forward pass there, fella. But we are now coming to the countdown rehearsal. And like I say, it's very, very simple. We need everyone here, all 30,000 of you, to make a heck of a lot of noise. So we're going to go from 10 all the way down to 0, counting in between when we get to 0, make some noise. You guys happy with that?
Happy.
You reckon this, you reckon Mount Smart Stadium's going to make a lot of noise?
Yes, indeed.
All right, Nick, take it away, big fella.
Thanks, guys. All right, Mount Smart Stadium, we've heard from the Tottenham fans. Are you ready? Are the English fans ready?
Rugby league here in Aotearoa, New Zealand. Yeah. That was pretty good, but there are 30,000 plus here. That only sounded like 5,000. Mount Smart Stadium, I reckon we could do a whole lot better than that.
Obvious.
I reckon we could do it, that we get noise control complaints from Hamilton. Yeah. So, English opponents, Thomas opponents, are you ready to do it one more time?
Give yourselves a round of applause. Now, one of the entertainment that we have off the field is Woody Word of Wisdom. So if you reckon you're the next William Shakespeare of Only Hunger, grab yourself one of these signs, grab yourself a pen, and right away. So my two beautiful models here have risen their sign here.
So Mark says, let the players do their thing on the field, we can do ours in our seats. Hashtag one love. And remember, you can win $1,000 with your sign, so make sure you get into it.
John, talk us through this sign, mate. There's a nice, good play going on.
Thank you so much. My one says, may the horse be with you!
So guys, as we said, you can win $1,000 if you write the wisest sign. That's what it was, the wisdom.
King Makoto, where under grass and ground lie once thunderous volcanoes, watching over the sands, the seas, the history of their domain and its works of art, over the cultures that live here, the people that play here, and the ones that stay here. Auckland, love your weekend.
Pretty exciting really, it's the day I'll get my new year, so I'm really looking forward to it.
You've got to go.
The set was fantastic. None of the music looks fantastic. I should be able to find a spot there for this.
Hey guys, thanks for your winning words of wisdom signs. Make sure you get them and write on them because you could win $1,000. We've been loving your passion so far here at Mount Smart Stadium, but remember to keep it in the stands, okay? If you're streaking on the field, it could be $5,000 fine or 3 months in prison. We don't want that, guys, do we?
No.
We want you to stay here and see more rugby league. It's going to be awesome. But now, it's time for our first performance of the evening. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Swizz!
Tom, are you ready? Yeah.
Yes!
Why the monkey just don't care?
Yeah.
See that?
my Bible well, but who was the character that was able to part the Red Sea? Which character was that?
It's Moses.
It's Moses. Moses was talking while he's talking to God.
Moses.
You guys having a great time, Mount Smart?
Guys, I'll jump in here. Who or what has been your favourite moment of this Rugby League World Cup 2017?
I think for me it's when I listen to the crowd singing with Tongan hymn.
That would be a great time to start one of those, do you reckon?
Absolutely. I cried and cried because I was so hard fun. I was so warm and excited.
Well, John has a great voice. Maybe if you lead us in the 30,000 plus Tongan fans here can sing along with you.
Okay.